here today representing the Bayer Group, and through this presentation, we intend to show you why our company will be the most important addition to your portfolio. For our agenda today, Haley will be discussing the Bayer Group and who we are. Allie will be giving us some corporate initiatives. I'm Melissa, and I'll be going over some financial figures. Angel will be talking about our competitive strategy, and Brianne will go over our product innovation.
The Bayer Group is a multinational German pharmaceutical and chemical company, which was established in Germany in 1863. It was originally founded as a chemical company specializing in the development and manufacturing of fabric dyes. However, in the early to mid-1900s, they experienced rapid expansion in the rest of Europe and the Americas, becoming a global leader in pharmaceuticals as well as in chemical products. The Bayer Group recently celebrated 150 years in 2003 as a global leader in pharmaceuticals. We currently have three core competencies, including healthcare, agriculture, and industrial products. Healthcare focuses on the research and development, manufacturing, marketing, and distribution of pharmaceutical products, animal health care, and medical products. Agriculture is our crop science division, and that focuses on modern and sustainable agricultural products and processes, as well as other chemical and biological products. Our material science is our industrial materials sector, which focuses on the development and manufacturing of polyurethanes, polycarbonates, and other industrial materials, including coatings and adhesives. The Bayer Group currently markets over 5,000 products, including aspirin, our flagship product, which most of you are likely familiar with. As a global leader and a multinational pharmaceutical company, we are committed to innovation, growth, sustainable practices, as well as environmental stewardship, and the creation of both wealth and value for our stakeholders. We do that via the development and implementation of our mission statement, which is Science for a Better Life, as we are dedicated to improving the quality of life on a global scale for both people and animals. We do this through a variety of large global scale initiatives, which are very unique to the Bayer Group and help to differentiate us from our competitors.
So Bayer's most important initiatives right now include those that create a potential for profit as well as satisfying our company values. So some of these include our research and development innovations through collaboration, our grants for targets and grants for apps programs, provide financial assistance to reputable research institutions that help accelerate the process from research to marketable technological and pharmaceutical products. And then we also have our collaborator centers, which are located in San Francisco and Berlin, Germany. And those provide research facilities and laboratories and office space for startup companies, and they're able to rent those so that they can kind of get on their feet. So by providing with these programs, we're able to invest in possible future employees, and we're able to mitigate our risks for research and development costs. And then another one of our important initiatives right now is the Contraceptive Security Initiative. And that targets middle-class women in developing countries in order to provide them with affordable oral contraceptives. So there had previously been issues where these median income women in sub-Saharan Africa didn't qualify for government subsidized birth control, and they also couldn't afford those medications that were offered by private institutions. So by partnering with USAID, we're able to expand our market to these women and provide them with affordable birth control, and we become a world market leader in oral contraceptives. And then we've also, through this program, have been able to reduce the child mortality rate, and we have increased maternal health. So clearly we are, through these initiatives, satisfying our goal of Science for a Better Life, and we're using partnerships to develop research and development goals that have made us one of the leading pharmaceutical companies.
So the main issue when it comes to investing is profit, and Bayer is a leader in this area. This figure here depicts Bayer on the stock market price of Bayer on the German stock exchange. And all figures will be in euros, so 1 euro is equal to 1.23 US dollars. And as you can see from this figure, over the past 3 years, Bayer has actually increased gradually in the stock market price. And as of last night at the close, you can see that actually went up 0.92%. And this here is an overview of our income, balance sheet, and cash flow for the past 5 years. And I just want to point out a few important key points, one of which is our net income has increased from 1.6 billion euros to 3.2 billion euros from 2009 to 2013. In 2013 alone, we increased our income by 30.38%. And our total revenue for 2013 was actually 40.16 billion euros, which was a very good, good thing for us. So as you can see, Bayer not only stands alone in the profit area, but also stands alone among our competitors. And this is a figure depicting Bayer as well as Monsanto's, Sanofi, and Novartis with their success on the stock market exchange over the past 5 years. And as you can see here, Bayer is a leader over time, and it continues to grow and increase and lead in this area. But staying on top is not easy, and that is why we have a unique competitive strategy that we implement.
As you can see, Bayer is a strong, reliable, profitable company. We already have strong market presence in the US and Western Europe. We've gone ahead and fortified that presence by acquiring emerging companies on prescription or over-the-counter medications. We're very proud of this acquisition because together these brands amount to $7.4 billion in sales. This is one of four unique items in our strategy, in our competitive strategy plan to ensure continued success. Our second point is that we're going to be filling material science. This is one of our profitable branches. However, it has been underperforming both crop science and health science. So as a result, we're going to float off as its individual independent entity so that we can bring out aid resources to these two areas which are most profitable for us. We are also using funds to expand into underserved target areas such as Latin America, Eastern Europe, Iran, and Asia. For example, in Argentina, we're going to be marketing drought-resistant weeds. In Asia, specifically, we want to market herbal products because they prefer those over chemical-based compounds. Our last point here is that we develop partnerships with other entities within the pharmaceutical industry. We have here a minute representation of our collaborators. We have some educational institutions that have been doing research for us. We have companies that are looking at the front end of product innovation. And all of this, of course, is with the intent to mitigate some of the risks associated to developing, well, first of all, finding them, developing and marketing new medications. Okay. So these are only four of our most salient features in our pursuit for market dominance. I think the key point here to take home with you is that when you invest with us, your money is going to be actively used to generate more revenue. It's not going to be sitting in accounting in our headquarters in Leverkusen, we're actually implementing expansions and growth, product innovation.
So Bayer is the company that you go to for high-quality, innovative products that also happen to be sustainably produced. Here are a few. Clearly, Bayer is more than just aspirin. I'm sure that among these, you recognize a few, but you've also used trusted them. It's important to note that we have over 60,000 valid patent applications pertaining to over 8,000 products worldwide. Our commitment to innovation is the reason that Bayer stays on top of all of its markets. So specifically, we're innovating to try and tackle today's biggest challenges, including population growth, an aging society, and limited natural resources. These are a few of the products that we released in 2013 alone. When it comes to population growth, our goal is to produce high-yield crops for food, feed, and sustainable renewable resources. Luna, Expro, and Serenade are three fungicides, while Votivo is a pesticide that we developed in hopes of combating this issue. An aging society is afflicted with with many different diseases, including cancer and stroke issues. These two drugs, Stivarga and Xofigo, are two specific cancer treatments, while Xarelto is a preventative blood thinner. In terms of limited natural resources, our crop science section is really key in producing seeds and treatments for producing sustainable agriculture, as well as our material science division, which developed a polycarbonate that's used in these wind turbines to make them longer and therefore produce more energy, and thus wind power becomes an actual viable energy source. It's important to note that not only did we release these products in 2013, but they actually were successful in the market. These, along with two others, brought us over 3 billion euros in sales in 2013 alone. This is the reason why Bayer continues to be successful.
So as you can see, Bayer is a very innovative and dominating force within the industry, and we hope that you will join us for the next 150 years of success. And with this, we're going to thank you for your time and open it up to questions that you may have at this moment.
Would you go back to that chart that had the bar charts with financial numbers on it? Yes. Now it looks like your sales and revenue growth is fairly flat, right, 1%. Any sense for what it would have been without the acquisitions? And does that suggest that maybe the market is softening for some of your core products? Or is there some other logic that would suggest that? Instead of sales and revenue growth, looks
right
like
here.
That's a five-year thing, is 1%, right?
Right here.
Yeah.
This is for 2013, this column here.
That's just 1 year?
Yeah. So this, the bar graph itself is the five-year, and this is just 2013.
That's
overview.
Income, which is growing quite nicely. Any sense for where the revenue growth will come downstream, or how much of that is from acquisition?
Downstream, I feel, will come from the crop sciences and the acquisition of Merck, because we did become a big force in the over-the-counter medications. So we do have a lot more to put on the market now. And our crop science is actually accounted for about 10% of the revenue of the company in 2013, so it's beginning to grow as well.
Now, is the disentangling of the material science operation that I believe you spoke about, is that just a financial trick? Or is there something substantive that...
Quick clarification, the fluorine has been approved to happen, but it actually won't happen until 2016. Right now we're in the process of going through all the legality of sectioning it off. It's already been voted as a yes, and we're at the level where we're going through antitrust legalities. But so these values would actually still include the revenue from material science.
I also noticed that, for example, you had the chart on the stock appreciation of Bayer plus the three other.
That's right.
It seems, for example, if you had picked a different starting point, like the start of this year, then Novartis wins. We all know that the presentation of data can sometimes mislead based on when you begin and kind of what you. So is there anything special about starting
It's important to show over time, just because if you invest, it will be a time thing. It's not just going to be for one.
Yeah, let's suppose you have to pick 1980 or 1975, and this is all kind of history, so kind of the key is sort of the future. So for Bayer, what are sort of the big cash cows? Where does most of the profit come from?
Most of the profit comes from the crop sciences and the health sciences, which includes our over-the-counter medications and our Merck acquisition. That's another reason why material science was floated, because it wasn't as big as an entity as the other two.
Our main reason for floating material science and separating it is to allow it to get its own capital aside from Bayer, so we can focus our finances on research and development in our life sciences, because that's where we're going to generate the most revenue. And the Merck acquisition is really just sort of a starting point as we expand our over-the-counter medications and move sort of more globally into untapped demographics such as Latin America, where we're going to focus on, instead of prescription drugs, which a lot of our competitors focus on, the non-prescription over-the-counter side of things.
Now, in terms of the kind of the consumer medical stuff, it appears that Bayer, is this sort of in the same kind of ballpark as J&J, Johnson & Johnson, because they have, Band-Aids and whatever. But here it appears you're kind of partnering with Angen, which is sort of a big-time biotech operator, whereas J&J has its own kind of research. So are there any kind of big blockbuster medical advances that are coming that we can expect, particularly for the aging? I'm appreciative.
We have some additional products in the pipeline for cardiovascular and gynecological issues that have promising profiles. In terms of big blockbusters, you can't get much bigger than Xarelto. It's one of the top-selling medications, especially in the U.S., because people are so afflicted with
heart. So who was the creator of that? Was it kind of Bayer? Was it one of the collaborators?
No, Xarelto is ours.
Do you know how much you spend on art research and development, or are you getting new technology from your own R&D or acquisitions?
A combination of both.
Okay. Do you know how much you spend on R&D?
For 2015, is projected to we're going to spend $6 billion just in the healthcare.
Just in the R&D.
Just in R&D, yeah. But that's just in the healthcare. I'm not sure about crop science.
Now aspirin is pretty much aspirin. So what has Bayer been able to do to kind of maintain this sort of aura of the aspirin to buy?
Right. The thing that's really neat about aspirin is that it started out just as an analgesic drug, 20 years ago. And it's been developed to be a lot more than that. Now people are taking it prophylactically to prevent stroke and heart attack. In addition, there's, children-sized aspirin, there's coated aspirin. So yeah, there's been development just within that product line alone, and it's well-received, and it's what we're known for, so there's no reason to let that go.
All right, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.